My name is Abraham Susiku from Wamis Agro Seed. I'm actually the Director of Production and Marketing. Wamis Agro Seed is basically a seed company, a local seed company that specializes in leguminous plants, seed production, and grain. We basically strive towards efficiency in the production of high quality grain, input credit, farmer training, and market in a profit, cost-effective, and timely to our customer. Our vision is basically to become one of the leading, one of the world's most leading seed production companies, not forgetting grain trader. The problems that we are trying to solve right now are simple and are known by everybody, but I'll go through. Lack of knowledge by farmers in sustainable agriculture and entrepreneurship. Lack of finance to access this is critical. Inability by small-scale farmers to access finance because they are basically considered to be a liability. Lack of coordination among small farmers to be able to aggregate and sell or make sense of off-taker. Easy access to affordable seeds by small scale is a problem. Then basically we'll go to our social value proposition. What we strive for basically as Wamis Agro Seed, we take pride in providing farmer solutions by producing and disputing quality seeds using farmers themselves. We offer credit loans, soft loans, farmer training. Then basically we also provide ready markets, this is key, ready market for whatever they produce, thereby improving farmer incomes, resulting in rural prosperity, which we constantly preach about. Basically, I'll try to make you go through the activities that we do: farmer mobilization, guerrilla warfare, conventional, we can survive with the big companies. So farmer mobilization in rural areas. Then basically we go to farmer training, mobilize, train them, excite them, start the fire, basically then provide inputs. Once you provide inputs, then we go on to pre-harvest and post-harvest monitoring. We make sure that quality is good. We provide market by buying, then take to our warehouse where we sort using manure. Then basically storage, then we distribute. With whom we cooperate, I think this will go on to our turnover. Basically our turnover is about 410,000 because of both seed and grain. Then our expectations from our investors, basically we seek investment of the sum mentioned, then the investment is needed to facilitate you understand we're using manual. So these are some of the things we hope of course to have in order to be efficient and make sense to the small scale farmers. Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Abraham, you obviously worked in an auction company, you were tobacco sales floors.
Well, what I'll say is that, I mean, no, but yes.
Okay. So I'm going to do something very naughty and I'll speak later. I want you to very quickly, you saw the t-shirts designed by Tanga. We'll donate one t-shirt to a lucky bidder. We'll have a quick auction. I just want to use this talent quickly. We're going to auction the t-shirt and we're going to make it easy. You will just call out at speed. That same speed you were using for your flash presentation. So we have a t-shirt for someone to auction for. And we're going to start, and I'm going to help. I see 50 cents bond. 50 cents bond. I see 50 cents bond. Make it a dollar. Make it two. I see the $2. $3. I hand it over to Abraham.
Okay, I see $500. $1,000 has it.
We'll continue the bid later. I think it stopped over there at $3. The $500 we'll get there. I'll call you back.
All right, thank you.
To proceed with our program, allow the jury to engage you. Thank you. Excellent.
Thank you for stopping because I only had quite some high value notes. If the company is growing as fast as you speak, I'm going to definitely want to invest in you.
Thank you.
Which is fine, but for the next presentation, I would try not to tell everything. but to focus on the things that differentiate you from the rest.
So I will definitely remember you.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you for your presentation. And indeed a lot of things to digest.
And I wonder how you do it without breathing. Three minutes without breathing is a lot of time.
My point, maybe a clarification. You mentioned sustainable agriculture.
And I want a definition. What do you mean by it?
All right. When we talk about sustainability, others are replacing it with empowerment. I believe that sustainability means being able to plant a seed. Then once it helps the seed to grow, eventually it needs to get to a point where it will stand on its own. Otherwise, all efforts are vain. So when I talk about sustainability, it's a situation where a small scale should be able to do business in agriculture. We understand what they have. Land is there, the passion for agriculture. But we understand what they lack. But by the end of the day, once we facilitate for that, these small scale farmers should be able to get a good price, ready market, make profit, and from that profit I feel they'll be able to sustain their lives. Now by sustaining their lives, it means that next year they'll be able to buy, they'll have buying power. Basically we have 75 to 80% of small scale farmers in Africa who have no buying power. You understand? They don't have buying power. So what happens with all our models is that we sell to the government, which buys on their behalf to give them. So this trade continuously continues. And the result is we're not doing anything. So yeah, we are doing something, but I'm saying we're not doing much to enable the person. Should the tsunami hit?
Thank you.
It's going down.
Thank you, Abra. You were moving with speed. I think good presentation. I've said comments similar to this before. Yes, it's good to understand how the business is doing financially, how sustainable it is. I see a bit of contract farming and credit supplying. Those are very important things, but on the other side it's also important to say a bit of how that is translating into improving, having positive impact on the smallholder farmers. Can always be argued that with contract farming, credit input scheme, the argument is always does it empower or does it impoverish smallholder farmers? So, a bit about that.